On June 30th.
Either with us or you against us.
Witness the untold story of a hip-hop legend.
This is Tupac.
All Eyez On Me.
Only in cinemas.
Headed east to an old club that was owned by Prince. About to pick up the homie Warren G. What's up, brother Warren?
What's up, man?
How you doing, man?
What's going on,
baby? All right, let's roll.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Nice to be riding around LA with the G-Funk Master, man. You know what I'm saying?
So, man.
You know, and I know it's a lot of memories, you know, around these areas.
Yeah, actually, I used to get down right here at the Glam Slam.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that was like our Roxy here on the West Coast. And, you know, we used to do a lot here, man, me and Pac, as far as just hanging out, partying, and, you know, also just freestyling. Pac was a cool cat, man. We did some records together, and you know, he performed, you know, one of the records that we did up here at the Glam Slam.
So as we riding around in LA and we on our way down to Echo Sounds, which is a very iconic studio, man, that you've done a lot of work at, you know what I'm saying?
I worked with Tupac there. We did Definition of a Thug Nigga. That was on the Poetic Justice soundtrack. And we did great. How Long Will They Mourn Me?
Oh, wow, okay.
You know, at that studio, and I had my MPC 60, my turntable, and a bunch of records, and my 45. Mm-hmm. And came up here, walked in, and it was Tupac. Mm-hmm. You know, he was like, let me hear some beats. We talked, and he was just like, you know, he was asking me, like, what was I going through? Like, what, because he could probably feel the tension I was feeling around that time. And I told him everything I was going through, and it was crazy because it was like he took everything in that I talked about and made Definition of a Thug Nigga. While we was in there, he had some girls come in and shit. You know, I wasn't used to a gang of pretty girls and being in the studio and shit. Mm-hmm. And I had glasses. I had tape on my motherfucking glasses and shit. Yeah. I hadn't got no money yet.
Right.
So the girls came in. That was the first time I ever hit a blunt. We was drinking
what?
Hennessy.
Okay, all right.
You know, I smoked joints,
but
that's the first time I hit a blunt.
So he really was cool, huh?
Yeah, he was a cool dude.
I never met him. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah. So. He was real cool. I was only charging $1,500 a track back then.
Oh, that's good.
But,
shit. Nobody
but you
was...
know what? But you know what? Him and Breed did.
Yeah.
When I did, you gotta get yours. I gotta get mine. Niggas gave me 8 racks.
That's cool. That's cool.
And for a motherfucker to not have no money and to get that, mm-hmm. I gave my sister money because I was living with her.
That's
I gave
cool.
my girlfriend money. I was. I thought I was lightweight rich.
Right. Hey, I totally get it. I totally get it. Tell me a little bit about this place in North Hollywood, man. What was the significance of track records for you?
It's a very special place. It's where I did You Gotta Get Yours, I Gotta Get Mine with Tupac and MC Breed.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and I also did my first album here, Regulate the G-Funk here, right
That's
here.
That's cool. Tupac wasn't around L.A. that long, right?
No, yes, he was.
Oh, he was. Okay, around. I wanted to make
he
sure.
He go all the way back to the NWA days around that time, hanging with, before he was, well, when he was with Digital Underground.
And then
being around Above the Law, they became real close.
Got you. Yeah, because I know he had a history in Oakland, and but it was so interesting to see that that Tupac was so heavily involved in a lot of the LA recordings as well, and even the studios, and you know, you can feel his presence still, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. It's just a cool neighborhood, man. And you know, it was fun, you know, working with guys like Tupac.
Mm-hmm.
And just seeing how the talent was just incredible, man. It was just off the charts. Just being able to produce some records for the first time for two well-known artists, you know, and I was a unknown guy.
Mm-hmm.
And Tupac gave me that chance, you know?
Yeah.
They called me and it was like, Warner, you got some beats. I was like, yeah. Came up, got inside, played some records for them. They liked it.
Big sight, new.
And the sky was the limit after that.
Big sight. Yeah. Y'all know how this shit goes, you know?
All eyes on me. Roll up in the club and shit. All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
All I'm trying to do is tell your story.
This is my music. I want you to feel every breath.
Either I do my own thing or I'm out.
Me, the man, the person. California.
All Eyes on Me. Only in cinemas.